tonight on Carolina News. Double standard? Many well-known leaders and celebrities are making headlines for sexual harassment allegations, but only some seem to be bearing the consequences. A step closer to war. North Korea's recent missile test shows the warhead is capable of striking the U.S. mainland and has many countries on edge.
If war comes, make no mistake, the North Korean regime will be utterly destroyed.
And Christmas tree galore. Christmas trees are popping up everywhere, and one school is using the holiday season to teach their awesome kids practical skills. Carolina News starts now.
From the University of South Carolina, your news, your sports, your weather. Carolina News begins now.
Hello and welcome to Carolina News. I'm DJ Chaffman.
Good afternoon and thanks for joining us. I'm Brady Brewster.
As allegations of sexual misconduct continue to surface, many of the accused are losing their jobs. But this isn't the case for some elected officials in Congress.
Our Katie Augustine is live in the newsroom with the latest on this story.
That's right, guys. When it comes to Hollywood bigwigs and sexual misconduct, in most cases, these men are respectfully admitting their mistakes, apologizing, and stepping down. But in Congress, Roy Moore, Al Franken, and John Conyers remain in office. The question is, are these cases being handled differently, and should they be?
From Harvey Weinstein to Matt Lauer, 35 men have been accused of sexual misconduct in the last 2 months, ranging from Hollywood producers and actors to politicians. And while people from Hollywood are resigning or being fired, elected officials such as Roy Moore, Al Franken, and John Conyers have remained at work.
In the case of politicians, I think some of the more high-profile ones have to do with the sensitivity of the particular offices they're seeking. For example, in the case of Roy Moore, it's become an even bigger issue because it potentially could change the balance of power in the Senate.
Does this mean that these politicians are escaping repercussions? Moore, Franken, and Conyers have all denied allegations of sexual misconduct, but Nancy Pelosi is calling for Conyers to step down.
I pray for Congressman Conyers and his family and wish them well. However, Congressman Conyers should resign.
In South Carolina, Congressman James Clyburn is receiving backlash after a comment he made suggesting elected officials should be held at a different standard when it comes to allegations of sexual misconduct.
Right? I don't know, you would have to give me some examples.
Harvey Weinstein, Charlie Rose, Matt Lauer.
I don't think they
Who elected them?
Who elected them? He asks. This poses the question, is it up to voters to keep these politicians from holding office? According to Professor Cox, the answer is yes.
I think that one of the issues for the politicians is that their voters need to decide it. And I would say that of Al Franken as much as Roy Moore. Because in the past, voters have punished people who have done inappropriate things.
And as of now, Moore, Franken, and Conyers have announced they will not be stepping down, and therefore it will be up to voters to decide their fate. Back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks, Katie. And right now, the topic of choice in the Senate is the GOP tax bill, with the final vote to take place before this week is over. It fell along party lines with a 52-48 vote. Republicans are hoping to have the bill passed by the end of the year. President Donald Trump visited Capitol Hill earlier this week in an effort to strengthen support for the bill. GOP leaders are still uncertain about the bill's fate, as they likely do not have the necessary votes for it to pass as of right now. But Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell is hopeful regarding the bill's success.
We're on the cusp of a great victory for the country, and particularly for small business.
McConnell also says tax relief is necessary to create more jobs and continue America's growth.
North Korea conducted another missile test on Tuesday amidst increasing tensions between the rogue regime and much of the rest of the world. This missile went higher than any of the previous ones the country has fired. It was launched from northeast of the North Korean capital, Pyongyang, and it landed 600 miles east in the Sea of Japan. U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations Nikki Haley warns North Korea that their actions continue to raise the likelihood of war.
The dictator of North Korea made a choice yesterday that brings the world closer to war, not farther from it. We have never sought war with North Korea, and still today, we do not seek it.
Haley went on to say that if war were to break out, the North Korean regime would be destroyed as a result of it.
And Katie is out in our weather center with a look at our first forecast. Katie, how's it looking out there?
Guys, this is some amazing weather that we're having for November. It's a little strange to have this time of year, but unfortunately it feels kind of perfect. We're expecting some sweater weather coming into the weekend, but right now it's around 71 degrees, low humidity. It feels great out. Now, like I said, we're going to expect some cooler temperatures going into the weekend. Maybe it's because we're expecting a little bit of rain tonight to bring those cooler temperatures in. And now the temperatures are actually starting to go down a little bit as the sunset is coming up around 5:15. We'll get some of those cooler temperatures tonight and into the weekend, but I have that and more coming up in my full forecast.
Thanks, Katie. The search continues for a missing toddler in North Carolina, east of Fayetteville, who has been missing since Monday. The FBI released a missing person poster of 3-year-old Mariah Woods. Woods stands at 2 feet 9 inches, has brown hair, and weighs around 30 pounds. On Tuesday, the FBI released photos of a woman carrying a girl through Walmart who was thought to be Woods, but authorities say that it was not her and the woman is not connected to the ongoing investigation. Anyone with information on the woman and the child pictured is asked to call the Onslow County Sheriff's Department or FBI. Unfortunately, we hear many stories about missing persons and theft during the holiday season. Lexington County deputies are still searching for one woman who went missing this past weekend. Our Jacqueline Lawson spoke with former Lexington Deputy Ben Spence about how you can stay safe this holiday season.
People's fears rise when they see headlines like this one. But the holiday season is in full swing, and the hustle and bustle that comes with the most wonderful time of the year can sometimes make people a little more distracted. But despite these distractions, the holiday season is when everyone needs to be a little more cautious.
Always watch where you are. Watch your surroundings. Be very cautious of people, you know.
But with more people out and about, what can you do to stay safe as the holiday season ramps up? Shop during the day and with other people. Always carry identification. Recognize when you feel rushed, distracted, or stressed. And be aware of strangers approaching you for any reason. But what happens if it's too late?
But I would kick and fight and bite and scream and holler because he doesn't want that attention. And if you're out in public, most of the time he's going to go. Or either it's going to draw enough attention. Everybody's going to get a tag number off a car. They're going to see him. They can identify him. But I would fight.
So whatever you're doing this holiday season, be sure to be careful and stay safe. Jacqueline Lawson, Carolina News.
Spence also added to always follow your gut feeling, and if you feel unsafe at any time, seek help immediately.
Tomorrow kicks off the annual Stuff a Bus campaign. Buses will be parked outside of 5 Walmart stores looking to collect unwrapped toys, food, and monetary donations to make sure that families have a Merry Christmas. The 5 Walmart locations are on Forest Drive, Orangeburg, Lexington, Manning, and Dutch Fork. The campaign will be held from 5 a.m. to 7:30 p.m. And Rockefeller Center held their annual Christmas tree lighting last night, keeping on with the tradition that started in 1931. The spectacle always draws a large crowd, and last night was no different. People packed in to watch performers and to see the 75-foot-tall tree light up. New York City's Mayor Bill de Blasio was the one to flip the switch this year, and with nearly 50,000 lights on the tree, the moment the lights came on was just the cap to a festive night in Manhattan and for all who were watching. And I have to say, I'm sad I didn't get to catch it last night, but I saw it a few years ago in person,
oh,
and
yeah?
It was really pretty cool.
Yeah, I've been meaning to make it up there, but haven't gotten around to it.
It's fine.
Not that close, but if you've been placing bets on which business will fill the old Harper's location, you may get your answer soon. Stay tuned after the break.
This is our game, our passion. This is what we live for.
He's caught for the win!
24-7.
He don't just run for first down. His man runs for touchdown.
This is where our season never ends.
This is a heck of a game.
From the combine.
This is why you want to run at the combine, because now you get another crack at it.
To the draft.
He hustles, he's tough, he's got Pro Bowl potential.
To the Super Bowl. all day, every day. Exclusive access.
It's training camp where the real work comes into play.
On the field.
What does this win do for the Vikings?
And off.
I realize what my purpose is now.
This is our history.
I wanted to play for anyone who would play the Packers.
Our next generation.
With the first pick in the NFL draft.
This is our everything. Showtime. This is NFL Network.
Where can you throw the best pregame tailgate in Charlotte without worrying about a thing? What about steps from Bank of America Stadium before Panthers home games? Three distinct hospitality villages will be sure to impress your guests. Gourmet food and beverage, stunning decor, live bands, and the best Panthers entertainment available. Learn more about corporate hospitality at panthers.com/tickets.
Restaurant in Five Points could be replaced by a popular fast food chain. The Five Points Association says Zaxby's is building a new restaurant where Harper's Restaurant used to be. Though the location is previously known for fine dining, Zaxby's applied for a zoning exemption with the City of Columbia to install a drive-thru window. Harper's closed its doors on April 18th after over 27 years of business in Five Points. The Board of Zoning Appeals will discuss the new Zaxby's location on December 12th. A new business is making a grand opening on Main Street today. The Grand, located at 1621 Main Street, is a new restaurant complete with a bar, arcade, games, and a bowling alley. While the building has a variety of food, board games, and drinks, it has historical value. David Keller, general manager of The Grand, says the building was created in 1909. It was used for showing silent movies and hosting various shows. Keller says he's amazed he's struck gold with a fun and historical building.
Learning how old this building was and the history that really lives in this building, and specifically in Columbia on Main Street, has just completely opened my eyes, and I love it now, and I love showing the historic sides of these buildings to people.
The Grand is open from 9 to midnight this week and Sunday, and until 2 a.m. on Friday and Saturday.
If you chose to stay at home rather than battle the stampedes on Black Friday, you're not alone. This Cyber Monday was the largest online shopping day ever, according to new numbers. By the end of the day, shoppers spent nearly $7 billion online. The most popular website was Amazon. From Thanksgiving to Cyber Monday, customers ordered hundreds of millions of products from the site. This news is great for other online shops, but maybe a warning for traditional brick-and-mortar stores. A Rock Hill veterinarian offered a second chance at life to a pit bull with the help of an animal rescue group. Debo the pit bull was surrendered by his owners when they could not afford his vet bills. He had ear and eye infections, along with numerous other issues. The owner had dropped Debo off to be euthanized, but Dr. Jonathan Setzer decided that he could be saved. Debo has regained his health over the last few weeks, and he will be ready for adoption in the next few months. Well, I just love to hear that a vet thought about saving his life before just immediately just doing it.
I feel like that's just a really just nice thing to do.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, and Katie is still outside with another look at the weather. Katie, how's it looking out there?
Guys, the sun is breaking through the clouds a little bit, but you can definitely tell they're starting to make their way in, and you can see and feel the temperature starting to drop a little bit. But how low will the temperatures actually go tonight? Find out coming up next in my forecast.
See on page 4 that projections need to be blood. Next Thursday?
Seriously? Thursday? Can't do that.
This is really inconvenient.
I have yoga that day.
I have no time for this.
So?
I can't do Thursday, but I can do Friday.
Disasters? Don't plan ahead. You can. Talk to your loved ones about how you're going to be ready in an emergency. Don't wait. Communicate.
appears these hot ashes are about to be dumped, which could possibly start a wildfire.
There.
How will Smokey deal with such a hot situation? The garden hose defense. Next, a thorough stir. Then another spray. And finally, feeling if the ashes are cool.
Oh, yeah.
Ah, yes, the selfie. A ritual practiced so frequently with this tribe, but not so much by Smokey Bear.
Only you can prevent wildfires.
Today marks the end of hurricane season in 2017. It was one of the most destructive Atlantic hurricane seasons ever recorded. Hurricanes Harvey, Irma, and Maria were some of the strongest we've seen. They ripped through parts of the Caribbean, Florida, and Texas, causing hundreds of deaths and billions of dollars in damage. This season saw multiple Category 5 hurricanes in the Atlantic and multiple Category 4s that made landfall. Well, I know it got tough there for a few months in some places, but we made it through.
Hurricane season's over. We made it through. We didn't see it too bad here in South Carolina, thankfully. And Katie is outside with your full forecast. Katie?
Yeah, guys, pretty fortunately, we didn't have to deal with too severe of hurricanes. We might get a little bit of rain tonight, though, but nothing in comparison. But currently in Columbia, we are actually seeing some pretty weird temperatures for November, 71, partly sunny, partly cloudy, getting a little bit of both right now. Low humidity, it feels very clear outside, and a low breeze at 4 miles per hour. And we will look across the state, pretty similar temperatures, 71 here in Columbia, and right around there, we're looking at the 70s too. Going up north, we're looking at 68, 67. And along the coast here, we're seeing some high 60s as well. Now for tonight's lows, it's really not going to drop too much. We're seeing 50s along the coast in Florence, Myrtle Beach. It's actually a little bit warmer down in Charleston tonight at 56, and even warmer down in Hilton Head at 58. Greenville and Rock Hill, low 50s, but nothing's really going to break into the 40s or anything colder tonight. Now looking in the nation, the reason we're seeing that is because temperatures across the nation are 10 to 20 degrees above average right now. I mean, look up in the west, we're seeing 46 in Seattle, 40 up in Billings, and 47 up in Billings, which is really weird for this time of year. Here, we're, you know, used to these temperatures, but not this time of year, really. 66 in Atlanta, still pretty warm for right now, 69 in Charlotte. And up in the coast, we're seeing some warm temperatures again. 51 in Buffalo, they usually have snow by now, so don't really know what we're seeing. And 80s down in Florida is pretty normal. So going into the weekend, like I said, it's going to be pretty clear. Tomorrow, kind of like today, we're seeing 69 as the high and 45 as the low, cloudy with some higher humidity. And as the cooler temperatures come in, we'll see that through this weekend. And we're going to see it into next week as we're expecting temperatures from 10 to 20 degrees below average. 57 as the high on Saturday, 39 as the low. So still above freezing, but we're getting those closer temperatures. And then Sunday, 65, it's going to start to warm up a little bit. 42 as the low, mostly sunny and higher humidity, but still overall great weather. Back to you guys.
Well, thanks, Katie. I mean, December's right upon us.
And it is 70
degrees. The 60s and the 70s, I don't know.
You
doesn't
know,
really make a ton of sense.
South Carolina.
Yeah, we are in South Carolina. But the World Cup is only 6 months away. And after tomorrow's draw, we will have a better idea of what to expect in next summer's tournament. We'll tell you what to watch for after the break.
Listen.
All it took was someone who would insist that I just try.
Suddenly, everything was turned around because they judge you.
You tell them, I don't need this.
No one is going to understand.
Unless they've been through it, how can they?
Then one day you realize...
You feel so hopeless.
I need help. I need help.
You feel so hopeless.
Then one day you realize...
Unless they've been through it, how can they understand?
I don't need this.
No one's going to judge you.
Suddenly everything was turned around because they insist that I just try.
All it took was someone who would just...
listen.
We just finished dinner and it was time for homework.
I hate homework. It makes no sense.
I don't know how he finds anything in his backpack.
I can't find my backpack.
I couldn't even read his handwriting.
Holding the pencil makes my hand hurt.
I know he's bright.
Why is it so hard for me?
He's just gotta try a little harder.
I'm trying as hard as I can.
When you can see learning and attention issues from their side, you can be on their side. Go to understood.org, a free online resource with support and tools to help your child thrive.
Look at you. You're at the top of your game. You're unstoppable. Nothing can throw you off track. Wait, is that your car? Uh-oh. Yeah, I saw that coming. That will throw you off track. You're looking at around 10 grand in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Let's try this again. Smart move. Because buzz driving is drunk driving.
The highly anticipated draw for the 2018 World Cup is set to kick off tomorrow in Moscow. The 32 teams who qualified will be split into four pots of eight teams. The big question is whether there will be a group of death this year, considering that pots will be based on FIFA rankings, a change from past World Cups. The draw being held in Russia is a critical sports moment due to allegations of corruption around the 2018 World Cup bidding process. The draw will take place at 10 a.m. Eastern Time. And I think it is safe to say that America maybe really messed that one up for us a couple months ago.
I mean, I'm still excited for the World Cup, but we're not going to be partaking in
not
that.
Not looking so good.
We'll jump right into things, guys. All right, the Gamecocks baseball schedule was released yesterday, and the 2018 season will begin on February 16th against Virginia Military Institute. The Gamecocks will have a total of 34 home games and will open conference play against defending national champions, the Florida Gators. The Palmetto State rivalry against Clemson will kick off March 2nd at Founders Park. And for a game to circle on the calendar, look no further than May 9th when the Gamecocks take on former head coach Chad Holbrook and his new team, the College of Charleston. This game will take place at Spirit Communications Park, the home of the Columbia Fireflies, the only game of its kind this year. The time has finally come, the return of Tiger Woods to the golf course. Woods is playing his first competitive round of golf in nearly 10 months. It was announced Monday that Woods will begin his latest return at the Hero World Challenge while playing a twosome with reigning PGA Tour Player of the Year, Justin Thomas. Their tee time started around noon. The 18-player field included eight of the world's current top 10, and only one, Tiger Woods, is outside the top 32. Woods had this to say going into the tournament.
When I finally started to get it to where, hey, I got a little pop on this thing. I can hit a little bit harder, and I started getting it. And then I started playing practice rounds with Ricky. That was fun to be able to go out there and say, I can keep up with him.
Now, for the Carolina News Play of the Day, special edition, because I have two plays of the week. Let's not get carried away now. You decided on your favorite play of the day first. I'll send you out to the King Power Stadium for Leicester City versus Tottenham. A nice sweeping ball from Mark Albright, and it's Jamie Vardy with a beautiful and coolly placed chip over the keeper. That's a world-class goal, and Vardy is definitely having a party. Take another look at it. Next, we take you out to the Air Canada Center, where the Hornets traveled to Toronto to take on the Raptors. Late in the second quarter, Dwight Howard posts up Jacob Poeltl. Howard hits him with the crossover, then throws it down hard on Serge Ibaka. That is one monstrous dunk. Both of them probably should be ashamed of themselves and probably could go ahead and grab their gear and head to the showers after that one. There's a lot going on. You can appreciate the Dwight Howard.
Love the Dwight Howard play.
Got the Cowboys Redskins playing tonight. Looking forward to that. Tiger Woods being back, man.
Tiger Woods is back.
That's what's been exciting
for me.
Happy
too. Coming up after the break, find out how one school is using the holiday season to teach their students practical skills.
Here comes the Heffley family.
Whether it's a short trip or a long haul.
Estimated time, 47 hours.
They will beg.
You're hungry? I'm happy to provide.
They will plead.
Deep fried butter on a stick.
But whatever you do, don't wimp out.
Now you're talking?
Make them buckle up.
They can't hurt.
Remember, safety first. Cheese curls, second.
Are you orange?
It's the last day of November, which means Christmas month is starting, and one school in Ohio is welcoming the holiday spirit. An Ohio school for students on the autism spectrum is converting their pumpkin patch into a Christmas tree farm. Their goal is to teach middle and high school students practical skills in unique ways. The school's director says students prefer learning outdoors rather than sitting inside a classroom. And I'm sure it's probably a little bit colder in Ohio than here, but I'm glad that they can get those guys outside.
Love to see that they're giving them something to do rather than just sit in a classroom all
day.
Enjoy
fresh air.
Yeah,
enjoy everything. Christmas! Like,
well, we all love Christmas. It's nice to do a little hands-on, too.
That's right. All right, Katie, can you give us one more look at that five-day forecast?
Well, I certainly wish it was starting to feel like that. We might get a little bit of that this weekend. It will start to cool down. Saturday especially, it's going to be around 57. But up until next week, it'll warm up a little bit until we experience actually some abnormally low temperatures. But we'll have that for you coming up next week.
I'm not going to lie. I know we've been trying to get in this cold weather, but it was pretty nice out today.
It felt really good out.
I like
about
it.
Nice
I like today.
That's what you want to feel like in the spring going into the summer. That's what you're expecting.
It's
not
December.
In the end of November.
I mean, December 1st is tomorrow, and it was, what, 3 degrees Celsius?
Well, I guess I'm not in solo this year.
Yeah, Matt, you're over there by yourself.
All right.
That's all the time we have today. Thanks so much for being with us.
See you all tomorrow. Have a great evening.